See here, our today's point is conditions for solubility. We are going to see some more examples depend on this. What is first question? See, for each of the following system of equations, determine the value of K for which the given system of equations has a unique solution. Okay, has a unique solution. Yesterday we have seen what is the ratio, how to compare the ratios when solutions are, there is a solution, there is unique solution, no solution, or infinitely many solutions. Okay, now here they have told us has a unique solution. Okay, unique solutions means everybody knows what is the, what we are going to see, a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. This ratios we are going to use. Okay, this condition we are going to use for the unique solution. Okay, so now as usual, this equations we need to bring in the proper form. So what we are going to do is solution first, x minus ky minus 2 is equal to 0. This is I am saying first equation, and second one is 3x plus 2y plus 5 is equal to 0. Easy, this is second equation. Okay, two equations we have now. Now as usual, we need to equate this with a1x plus b1y plus c1, and this is a2x plus b2y plus c2. We need to compare. Okay, so directly also we can write now here, what is a1? A1 is equal to 1. Okay, what is a2? A2 is equal to 3. What is b1? B1 is equal to minus k. B1 is this coefficient of y is b1, that is minus k, and b2 is equal to 2. B2 is 2. Okay, so now this, according to this ratio, already I have taken this. Okay, when unique solution is there, that time we need to use this. So a1 by b2 is not equal to b1 by b2. This is for unique solution. Unique solution. So now a1, what is a1? 1 by 3 is equal to minus a by 2. Minus a by 2. Okay, so as usual, here we need to do cross multiplication. So minus 3k is equal to 2. So k is equal to 2 by minus 3, that is minus 2 by 3. Okay, or minus 2 by 3 or 2 by minus 3. Anyhow, it is same. So this is not equal. This is not equal. Okay, so what we can see here, what is the question? See, for each of the following system of equations, determine the value of k for which the given system of equation has a unique solution. Okay, so k is not equal to minus 2 by 3. Okay, so what we can say here, given system of equation will have unique solution. Unique solution. Okay, unique solution, that is k is not equal to minus 2 by 3. Unique solution for all real values. For all real values other than minus 2 by 3. Why other than minus 2 by 3? Because k is not equal to minus 2 by 3. Okay, so this statement is required in the last. Okay, so what is given, what we have done, two equations were given. We need to write in the proper form. Okay, a1x plus b1y plus c1, or a1x plus b1, ax plus by plus c. Okay, so according to this, we have taken a1 a2 b1 b2. Only two, these two values are required from each equation, because we know the ratios. When unique solution is there, that time a1 by b2 is not equal to b1 by b2. So a1 by b2 is 1 by 3 is not equal to minus k by 2. So 2 minus 3k is not equal to 2. Cross multiplication we have done, so k is not equal to minus 2 by 3. So in the last we have written here, given system of equations will have unique solution. We have unique solution for all real values other than minus 2 by 3. For all real values of k. Values of k other than minus 2 by 3, because k is not equal to minus 2 by 3. Okay, see here one more example we are going to see here. 2x minus 3y is equal to 1. As usual, now we need to bring in the proper form. 2x minus 3y minus 1 is equal to 0. Kx plus 5y minus 7 is equal to 0. This is first equation, this is second equation. Okay, what is a1? A1 is equal to 2, a2 is equal to k, b1 is equal to minus 3, and B2 is equal to plus 1. Okay. So A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2 because there is a unique solution. So now 2 upon k is not equal to minus 3 by 5. Okay. So minus 3k, we can find out product minus 3k is equal to 5 to the 10. So k is equal to 10 by 3, minus 10 by 3. K is not equal to minus 10 by 3. K is not equal to minus 3 by 3. So again we can write, given system of equations will have unique solution. You have unique solution for all real values, all real values of k other than minus 10 by 3. Okay, so same statement we need to write here. Given system of equations will have unique solution for all real values of k, for all real values of k other than minus 10 by 3. Okay, because k is not equal to minus 10 by 3. Okay, so we have seen two examples of first step. Okay, now we are going to see second step. Okay, see here, our next question is, for each of the following system of equations, determine the value of k for which the given system of equation has infinitely many solutions. Okay, we have seen this condition. When there is infinitely many solutions, that time what is the ratio? What we can say, A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C1. Okay, we need to use this ratio. Okay, when there are infinitely many solutions, that time. Okay, so first we need to bring 5x plus 2y minus 3 is equal to 0. 10x plus 4y minus 3 is equal to 0. Okay. So a1 by b2, b1 by b2 and c1 by c2. Okay. So that I am taking here a1. What is a1? 5. a2 is equal to 10. b1 is equal to 2. b2 is equal to 4. Then c1 is equal to minus 3 and c2 is equal to minus 3. Okay, there are infinitely many solutions, so we are going to use this ratio. So a1 by b2, 5 by 10 is equal to 2 by 4 is equal to minus k by minus 3. Okay, 5 by 3 means 1 by 2, 2 by 4 means 1 by 2. Okay, so any one ratio we can choose for the cross multiplication. So we can take here 1 by 2, 1 by 2 is equal to minus k by minus 3 is what? K by 3. So 2k is equal to 3. So k is equal to 3 by 2. K is equal to 3 by 2. So what we can see here, given system of equations will have infinitely many solutions when k is equal to 3 by 2. Okay. Because k is equal to here. So here we can write, given system of equations will have infinitely many solutions when k is equal to 3 by 2. K is equal to 3 by 2. Okay, now see one more example I have taken, that also we will solve here. K minus 3 into in bracket k minus 3 into x plus 3y is equal to k, kx plus ky is equal to 12. So that we can write here, k minus 3 into x plus 3y minus k is equal to 0, kx plus ky minus 12 is equal to 0. Okay, now as usual, as same as this example we need to solve. So what is a1 here? A1 is equal to k minus 3, a2 is equal to k, then b1 is equal to 3, b2 is equal to, again there is a k, c1 is equal to minus 12, sorry, c1 is equal to k minus k, and c2 is equal to minus 12. Okay, actually this is not necessary to write directly, we can put here. Okay, so I am taking this here, a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2, because there are infinitely many solutions. Okay, so all the ratios are equal. So now I am taking here a1 by a2. What is a1? K minus 3 upon k is equal to 3 upon k is equal to minus k upon minus 12. Okay, minus k upon minus 12 is, that is plus, positive. Okay, so what we can say, if I am taking here product, which product you will choose here? Okay, so here first I am going to find out this with the help of these two ratios. So k into k minus 3 is equal to 3k. Okay, so this k will be cancelled. We can cancel here only. So what is going to be here? K is equal to 3 plus 3, k is equal to 6. Okay, with the help of these two ratios, we got here k is equal to 6. Now, if we are going to think about this, minus minus gets cancelled. So what is remaining? 12, 3s are 36. 36 is equal to k squared. So k is equal to what? K is equal to plus minus 6. K is equal to plus minus 6. Here we have plus 6 and here also we have plus minus 6. So we will choose a common value. So k is equal to 6. K is equal to 6. So what statement you will put here? Given system of equation will have infinitely many solutions where k is equal to 6. Okay? Given system of equations will have many solutions if k is equal to 6. Okay, got it everybody? In such a conditions, we need to solve here the form k is equal to 6 plus 6 we have. Here we got plus minus 6. So, from both we have positive value. We need to choose. So, k is equal to 6 is the correct answer. Okay, so this we have seen infinitely many solutions. Okay. We are going to see now third one. For each of the following system of equations, determine the value of k for which the given system of equation has no solution. Okay, before this we have seen unique solution, infinitely many solutions, and now no solutions. Okay, so you know that when there is a no solution, that time what is the ratio? A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 but not equal to C1 by C1. Okay, when this ratio occurs, that time there is no solution. Okay, so now here as usual we are going to think about this. Now already this is given in the proper form, so directly I am taking value. What is A1? A1 A2, B1 B2 and C1 C2. What is A1? 3k, B1 B2 is minus 4, 3 and this is 7 and minus 1. Okay, 7 and minus 1. Now, as see here, B1 by B2 is not equal to C1 by C2. What is B1 by B2? B1 by B2 is not equal to C1 by C2. Means minus 4 by 3, minus 4 by 3 is not equal to 7 by minus 1. 7 by minus 1 is not equal. Means definitely there is no solution. There is no solution. Okay. So, what we can say now, we can use these two ratios. Okay, so that I am going to do here, A1 by A2. What is A1 by A2? A1 is 3 by k is equal to minus 4 by 3. 3 by k is equal to minus 4 by 3. So, minus 4k is equal to 9. So, k is equal to minus 9 by 4. K is equal to minus 9 by 4. K is equal to minus 9 by 4. Okay, so now, k is minus 9 by 4. So what statement we can give here? The given system of equation will have no solution when k is equal to minus 9 by 4. When k is equal to minus 9 by 4. So here we can write given system of equations will have no solution if or when k is equal to minus 9 by 4. K is equal to minus 9. Okay, got it everyone? Okay, here second example is given. 2x minus ky plus 3 is equal to 0 and 3x plus 2y minus 1 is equal to 0. Okay, so now what we can see here, a1 by a2. Okay, what is a1 a2? b1 b2 and c1 c2. What is a1? a1 is 2. 3, b1 is minus k and this is 2, here c1 is 3 and this is minus 1. Okay, so now according to the condition, a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 but not equal to c1 by c2. These two ratios are not equal to the third region. Okay, so here see, if I mean, see this minus k by 2 is equal to 3 by minus 1. Here k is given. Okay, so if I will say this ratio is not equal to this, according to this, okay, this ratio is also not equal to this, and this ratio is also not equal to this. So I am using this a1 by b2 should not equal to the c1 by c2. So there is no solution. So we can see this a1 by a2 is 2 by 3 and c1 by c2 is 3 by minus 1. So definitely these are not equal. Understood. So now what we can say, we can find out value of k with the help of these two ratios. So a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2. Okay, so that we can write a1 by a2 is 2 by 3 is equal to minus k by 2. So minus 3k is equal to 4. So k is equal to minus 4 by 3. K is equal to minus 4 by 3. Okay, so here we can write the last statement as same as this. Given system of equation will have no solution when k is equal to minus 4 by 3. Okay, so today we have seen all the three types, how to find out value of k in all the three types. First we have seen unique solution, when system of equation will have unique solution. Secondly, we have seen when infinitely many solutions, and last we have seen no solutions. Okay, so solve the same example again in your notebook, worksheet also, and some examples are given in the NCERT textbook. So solve all the examples. Thank you very much.